Hello, everyone. We are continuing our study of the Old Testament book of Ecclesiastes. We are in chapter 6 today. The teacher is the speaker, and we know the teacher to be King Solomon. And at this point in the book, he has been exploring the futility of wealth. Listen to this at verse 1. "There is another serious tragedy I have seen under the sun, and it weighs heavily on humanity. God gives some people great wealth and honor and everything they could ever want, but then he doesn't give them the chance to enjoy these things. They die, and someone else, even a stranger, ends up enjoying their wealth. This is meaningless, a sickening tragedy." He goes on to describe a hypothetical man who has 100 children and has lived a long life. Now, those two things were measures of individual prosperity at the time. In our more materialistic world, he might have used the car that they drive and the house that they live in. It would be like saying, there was once a man who drove a Jaguar and parked it in the driveway of his 6,000 square foot house on top of the highest mountain in the metropolitan Phoenix area. All right, so this is somebody who has all of the external trappings of immense prosperity. But then in King Solomon's version of this man, his life is meaningless and he's not enjoying anything that he has. And I'm afraid to say that we probably know people like this already. And in fact, maybe if you look hard in the mirror, you might recognize yourself as being such a man. Unfortunately for me, I've met several men in particular, who have been in this kind of scenario. One comes to mind right now. This was a gentleman who he'd had 3 children. They were all older by the time I met him. If you had looked on their Facebook page, you'd see that he had provided for them tremendously. They'd gone on great vacations as a family together, had amazing experiences. Obviously, his wealth was a big part of that. But his relationship with his kids was estranged at best. They had all grown and left the house, and he had very little contact with them. When I met him, we were talking, and he explained that he realized that his marriage was not as healthy as it should be, but his strategy was this: to continue to work hard because he was just a few years away from retirement. He would make sure that he had the best retirement fund possible, and then after he retired, he would go ahead and take his wife out on great vacations, and that would renew their marriage. It was as though he said something to the effect of, "I'll give her that honeymoon that I promised her 35 years ago." Well, he did continue to work hard, but his marriage didn't last till retirement. And now he was left with his children at a distance, his wife gone. Oh, he still had plenty of money, but what did he have to show for it? He had worked so hard and never enjoyed any of what he'd really had in front of him. And the teacher gives a cutting conclusion at verse 9 when he writes this: "Enjoy what you have rather than desiring what you don't have. Just dreaming about nice things is meaningless, like chasing the wind." The teacher saying, listen, appreciate what you have right now. We do spend too much time thinking about the future and how to arrange for it to happen to give us the maximum amount of opportunity. But the truth is, there are things that we have right now that God has given us that we should be appreciating and enjoying, living in the moment. It's a silly movie that I saw recently, Kung Fu Panda. And in it, there is a character whose name is Master Oogway, who has this pearl of wisdom. He says, "Yesterday is history, tomorrow a mystery, but today is a gift," which is why they call it the present. God has given us a gift in this day. Whatever that gift may be, we need to learn how to appreciate it and celebrate it and live in the moment where God has surrounded us with so many amazing things. When we learn to live that way, and appreciate God's gifts in the now and God's opportunities in the present, then the future will sort itself out when we just trust God to let that happen. We can continue to read where at the end of this chapter, the teacher, Solomon, will discuss the idea of destiny and our humanity's inability to know what God is doing in the future. But the point I think that we want to walk away with from this chapter is, absent God, our attempts to secure our future will end up being meaningless. So enjoy what God has given you right now. And as you go into this day, recognize the gifts and opportunities that God has given you. Celebrate them, enjoy them, embrace them, and most importantly, share them with others. Have a great day, everyone. If these devotional videos are helpful to you, subscribe to our channel and click the notification button so you know when we post a new video. And of course, please share them with others.